Good afternoon, guys. Today I want to share with you one of the most aggressive decks currently in Duelist available. We are playing a Vanna hyper aggressive deck with Feya Bloodwing. And the hand is quite good. We are starting, so we want to have a decent 2-drop. We could use the Heart Sister. Let's drop the Spelljammer. And we're getting the Primus Fist. So the Primus Fist is stronger than the Heart Sister, and we are playing the Heart Sister first. Going against another Feya Bloodwing. It's playing a Dreamgazer and a Yuxi. Also starting here with a Heart Sister, so that one is dying. We are playing the Tiger, taking the top, the bottom mana tile, also killing the Heart Sister here. And here we have the Wings of Paradise. Whenever I replay the card, then this minion gets +2 attack this turn. So he's a decent 5-3 in most cases. Next turn you will be able to use the Bloodbond spell. That means he can do 2 damage in the general's column. So the Tiger would be dead then. Killing the Tiger, sadly. Playing a Snow Chaser, also dealing 2 damage. So I'd like to move the Regeneral down here. We're also starting to attack the General. We are playing the Snow Piercer for 2. For 3 extra damage, so he's now dealing 5, also playing Bloodbond spell. That means he'll 7 damage this turn and brings him down to 11. Also getting a Bloodthorn Tier Alchemist. The mini jux might die next turn to the Bloody Alchemist. We have to see how much damage we can put out. So we are drawing another card, that's the Frostbone Naga. That will deal 2 damage to all minions and generals around her. So we can put her here. That will kill the Snow Chaser and also deal 2 damage to both minions and to the general. That will leave us with 1 mana left, so we can also kill the mini jux with the Bloody Alchemist. But we have to see first, we are at 14 now. And he can do 2 damage, also 7 damage on the top, so that will be 9 damage. And we are at 14. So I'm going for the bigger minion here at the top and not kill the mini jugs. 2 damage to the face. Getting the tiger that can do 5 damage next turn with the Primus Fist. What was he playing? Cryogenesis. Also dropping a Crystal Cloaker, another Snow Chaser. So the Bloodbond spell will deal 2 damage. Primus Fist and the Sapperspin Tiger will do another 5. And we have exactly 6 mana. So that will finish the game here. In the second game we are going against the Blight Chaser Abyssian. Let's see how this one goes. We are going second. Having the Warlocks, that's great. Also the Tiger is good. Primus Fist. Getting Frostfire and a Chromatic Cold. I just keep the hand here. That's good for now. Playing the Gloom Chaser as a start. Let's play the Warlock. That will deal 3 damage to both generals. We will also play the Chromatic Cold, so the Gloom Chaser can't kill the Warlock, and we might be able to deal 3 damage next turn to the general. Getting another Chromatic Cold. That's a Zorlek and a Abyssal Crawler and also a Blood Tear Alchemist, that's sad. So he is killing the minion. Going for the Tiger. And dealing 5 damage. Another Primus Fist. Getting 2 Wraithlings and the one on the top to the general will die, of course, to the Bloodbond spell. We are replacing one of the Primus Fists. Getting a Frostbone Naga. So let's see, we can can use a Bloodbond spell here. Dealing 2 damage. Then moves the general to this position. Also plays a Frostbone Naga to kill both his minions. And also dealing damage. Then hits the general for 2, brings him down to 9. The Primus Fist and the Frostfire are able to buff the Naga up to 7, So that might be enough to kill him next turn. Not with the Dark Transformation, unfortunately. So right now we just have the Chromatic Cold and the General. So we need to replace a card. I don't want to replace the Chromatic Cold here. Primus Fist is only good if we are drawing another charge minion. And let's replace the Spelljammer. Getting a Crystal Cloaker. Play it here. We're also buffing it with Frostfire. And let's put out the Primus Fist. So he's not able to attack our general directly. This is no piercer. Would have needed it earlier. But it might still be enough to kill him. General's attack power right now is 2, plus a Snowpiercer, that will be 5, and the Chromatic Cold will do another 2 damage, so he is doing exactly 7. So he will kill the Crystal Cloaker and make the way free for us to hit him. So that means he dies next turn. In the third game we are going against the Lyanna, keeping the Bloody Alchemist, the Heart Sister, and we will drop one of the Frostfires, hopefully getting another minion. It's a Crystal Cloaker, that's great as well. We are starting the game. We will put out the Crystal Cloaker at first. And on the next turn we might play the Heart Sister with the Bloody Alchemist. The Wings of Paradise is also good. So with the Silver Garden Eye on the bottom, we might just go with the Crystal Cloaker onto this position, above it with the Frostfire. Might be interesting. We will also play the Bloody Alchemist on the top. So he's now 7-6. We're hitting for 7. The general. Bring him down to 17. Our own general will move to this space and not there, so he can't provoke it. And next turn we might to dispel it. Unfortunately, he's gonna kill the Cloaker. Playing another Silver Guard Knight. So let's dispel this position here. Also attacking the general for 4, bring him down to 13. And our general hit him for another 2, so he is now down to 11. We will keep the Hearth Sister for now and replace the Wings of Paradise. Getting a Tiger that will deal another 3 damage. We also have the Bloodborne spell next turn. The Hearth Sister might be great against the Silverguard Knight. We are moving the Primus Fist to this position. And now let's see, it will die to the general. So we needed the Hearth Sister first. It's a bit unfortunate. Could play the Araki Headhunter here, then play the Heart Sister there, so we still can kill it with the Primus Fist. But in this case we can't play the Tiger. Let's see, let's play the Headhunter there. Heart Sister on this position, we are swapping it with the Silverguard Knight. Move the general to the bottom. Hit for 4. We can also play the Bloodborne spell, so the Silverguard Knight will die. And he's currently down to 5. Silverguard Knight is here only a 1-3 because he's not near the general. The Snowpiercer is great, he only has 5 life left, and the Tiger will also deal 3 damage. And next turn we will also be able to play the Bloodborne spell again. So all in all, that should be enough. He's not getting any provoke minion. The moose will kill the Hearth Sister. General will go to the top. So that is enough. Just putting out the 8-8. Can't stop us. Also killing the Araki here. So playing the Bloodborne spell for 2. Down to 3 life, and then we will play the Tiger and hit him for the remaining 3. If you have enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe and check out my other content as well. You can also follow me on Twitter and Twitch, as well as supporting me on patreon.com. Thanks for watching the video and see you soon!